Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Bot Squad podcast. We are at episode number 75.
Oh,
we got 25 more to go. Okay, 25 more to go to reach the triple digits. So we're almost there. We say that almost every time now. We're almost there.
We're almost there, yeah.
But we are anyway, almost. As always, I'm David, and I'm here with...
John.
You sound so excited.
I am. I'm very excited. I was just fooling there, but my name is John.
What are we drinking today, man?
I don't know, David. Just put one in your glass, none in your hand. And anyways, all right, I'll do it, you jerk. Okay, David picked this up today. David went out and got some New Belgium beer, okay? And we've had New Belgium beers before on here. We had Snapshot, we've had Fat Tire, really cool. And I think we had Ranger. This is a Voodoo Ranger, man. So I'm really guessing cool. What happened is all the other beer that they made from Ranger probably died, and then they did some Voodoo Chant, and then
fermented it, and then just threw it back.
Yeah, together. And then but they made it.
What if this was all just like the leftovers?
You know what?
I don't know.
No, hold up, man. That
you think so?
Yeah, you never know. They just slap on a new. You know, just
throw it on there. Oh, hold on. Let's get that hair out of there first. Anyway, so yeah.
But it's an Imperial IPA.
9%.
9%. That's crazy. Yes. Yeah, that's what you expect from an Imperial. You know what I mean? Imperial.
Imperial.
You know what? It should have had like... anything dealing with, like they're saying Imperial, should have like a Stormtrooper on there on or, you know, something.
Damn. Anyway, I'm stoked to check this out.
Look,
I got my own.
Where's your Captain America shield?
I don't know. I've been looking for it. I think it got lost somewhere around here in this craziness. It's here.
Anyway,
look. And this is... Okay, this is the one thing I don't understand. I got this one. They sent it to me when they gave me a review copy of Deepwater Horizon.
Ooh, this smells good.
It's a bottle opener about Deepwater Horizon, which was a disaster at sea. Oil rig at sea.
Oh, the what's his name? Yeah. Mark Wahlberg movie, but right?
This has nothing to do with the movie. I mean, yeah. I would understand if it, you know like they saved the day with a bottle opener.
You know what that reminds me of? Like if you work at an office and then they just throw their name on cheap little items to give out to like clients and stuff like that, like pins and rubber bands or some shit.
that's what it feels like. Luis Hernandez on YouTube said, "Funny, I was just watching your Switch unboxing and then got reminded that you're live right now."
Oh,
awesome!
All right, awesome. Yeah, and
just so, a neat little happenstance.
Solodens is saying that he wants to see me and you play the Switch.
Oh, 1-2 Switch.
Uh-huh.
Oh, that we don't have 1-2 Switch right now.
Is that that fighting one?
It's that one. It's like a. It's kind of like the equivalent of like Wii Sports, where you're like going one, you know, you get, they have ones where you can milk the cow.
What?
Yeah, eat a sandwich or something.
No.
Yeah. We will. I'm not doing this. We will eventually.
Okay. All right. Fine. Whatever.
But not. We don't have it
until
right
then.
Now.
This beer.
Yeah. Taste it. Not bad.
Oh, I love this.
Not bad. It has a good little like sweet flavor. Right at the end.
I love this.
This is really good.
I love this.
Oh man,
this is so cool, man. I was telling my kids about how they're not never gonna play it if I buy it.
I was telling my kids that they were never gonna play it.
Oh, I need this. This is good, man.
It's nice. Is that like this refreshing taste to it? Really good.
That damn that hop taste doesn't stand out real bad in this.
Hoppy, hoppy, hoppy.
It's good, man.
Oh yeah.
Damn it.
Luis Hernandez, again on YouTube, where did you find the beer? We actually found this beer at HEB. I don't know if you guys have HEB where you're at. I think HEB is a Texas
it is,
store,
yes,
I believe.
If you don't have it at an HEB,
any big supermarket
would carry
you
it.
You should have like something like that.
Preferably like your Randall's or your Kroger's and stuff like that.
Yeah. See, I don't know what's outside of outside of Texas. I think Kroger's is outside of Texas though.
Everything cool's here.
I don't know about that.
They got apple trees and stuff like that over there.
You remember Apple Tree?
Yeah.
It's an old-ass store. Anyway.
Didn't make it.
Let's go ahead and jump right in. First off, we're going to go ahead and talk a little bit about this cool little event that I went to. And it was actually put on by Barnes & Noble for the release of The Legend of Zelda Art and Artifacts hardcover book, right? So that's really cool that they put something like that on. I was really surprised. You know, I was telling John about it yesterday, and I showed up to that place. First off, I called John to see if he could go with me, because I get kind of anxiety sometimes whenever I'm by myself and there's a whole lot of people. I get a little bit of anxiety. I called him up. I was like, hey, man, are you free? You know, I just found out they're doing this thing at Barnes & Noble for the release of the book. And he was like, oh, man, I'm on a boat. I'm on a boat. I'm on a boat.
I was on a damn ship.
Barge.
Yeah, I couldn't get off of it.
And he was working. So he'd been there for, what, like
a week?
A week?
Yeah.
Like day and night. So he was stuck there. And he was super bummed out. And I was like, oh, man.
Dude, I contemplated. I was thinking
about it. You're going to jump off and swim?
No, hell no. I wouldn't even jump in that nasty water. But I was like really... I was thinking I was going to tell the deckhand, hey, man, take me ashore, and I'll call somebody to come pick me up. You know what I mean?
Come right back. Look, put a jet ski right there. Yeah. Then.
Man, because it sounded really cool the way he described
but
what
literally,
it was going.
I mean, I was like super like, oh, my God, okay. I was like, do I go? Should I go? Do I go? Should I go? I'm going to go. I'm going to go. Okay, I'm going. I have to go. It's Zelda. I have to go. No, but I don't know. Okay, I'm going. That's it. You know, I was literally fighting with myself. Just like Jim Carrey in Liar Liar.
Oh.
I'm kicking my ass. Do you mind? But anyway, so I drove out there to River Oaks, which is a good distance away from where we live.
Yeah.
I would say at least a good like 35-minute drive, something like that, more or less. And went out there and went to the event. It was a big 2-story Barnes & Noble. And I got really anxious. Because there was so many people. I would have to say about like 200, about 200 people showed up. A lot of them were dressed up like Link from The Legend of Zelda, which was really weird.
Were they all green, or did anyone have different tunics?
Different colors.
Oh, really?
All of them were different colors. There was even a Shadow Link.
Oh.
Yeah.
Did you take pictures?
No, I didn't. I try not to be weird, so...
Man, okay.
And I was trying to get my anxiety in check, too.
But okay, you know what? David walks around maybe a lot of times, but he'll walk around this big-ass Nikon, and in the one time he goes to an event like this, he doesn't take it.
Yeah, I know.
All right, man.
Anyway, gotta cut me some slack on this one, man.
No.
So, go out there, and the whole point was that they give you this map, and... if you're not on YouTube and you're on Instagram, you can see it here. It's a map, and it has various stops on it. You can see there.
Ohio, Houston.
And each stop is an area within Barnes & Noble.
Uh-huh.
And you stop there, and then a person asks you a certain amount of questions. Like about three questions at each stop. And they're trivia questions for The Legend of Zelda. And I was a little nervous that I wasn't going to get them. Like, I was like, man, how specific are they?
Yeah.
You know? And... So, go to the first one. It was like basic questions. You know, what color was the first cartridge of Legend of Zelda? Gold. You know, simple stuff like that. Ganon was the first boss, you know, of the game and stuff like that. I was there and I went to each stop. And each stop, I just started, like, kind of like word vomit. The answers just started coming out, right? And it got to the point where I was answering before everybody else, and I was getting my thing signed first, and people were just following me to each stop.
All right,
and then I get to the last stop. The fifth stop is supposed to be Hyrule Castle, which was just some lady at a table, and she had been following the group around, just making sure everything was legit, everything was okay.
Yeah.
And we get to the I get to the table, and she looks at me. She's like, "Oh, you've been answering the questions all night." She's like, "I'm not even gonna ask you the questions. Here you go." And what she did was that she gave me this limited edition pin right here. See, if you're on YouTube, get a closer look at it there. All right, really cool metal pin. And that was it. You know, I was like, okay, bye. Well, you know, I was trying to get the lady's attention because, you know, again, John wasn't there. And it was it super bummed me out that he missed something really cool like that, right? I kept telling her, like, you know, I'm sorry, excuse me, you know, can I get an extra? She said, no, I already gave you one, right? I go, yeah, but, and then she started walking. I'm like, ma'am, you know, can I get an extra one? And she just kept going, and I kept trying to follow her, trying to get her attention, and she was just, like, walking away. So I was like, damn it, man. So it was one of those things that just, it was a super big bummer for me. Because, you know, again, you missed out on
it's cool, man.
And, you know, I posted.
Thank you.
I posted on Instagram, you know, about it and stuff like that. And I posted, you know, like, man, if anybody has an extra one, that would be great. You know, for him, that would be super awesome. And the one thing that I didn't tell you was that I got a message the next day.
Oh, yeah?
From Barnes & Noble, River Oaks.
All right.
And they said, oh, I just saw your message. Thank you for coming. We actually have an extra one. If you want to come and get it.
Oh, damn.
I was like, oh, okay. All right. And she was like, well, let me get your name. So, got my name down. Stuff like that. And I drove out to Barnes & Noble, River Oaks,
for your pin. Is that where you went today?
No.
No?
I went there. I've been holding on for that thing for a week.
Oh,
I was keeping it a secret so that way I could give it to you here on the podcast.
Well, finally, like some nights he's always, every time he holds up, thank you, David. Like every time he holds something against me, I can't even. This man.
So the lady was very nice. So big shout out to Barnes & Noble, River Oaks, for doing us a great solid
man.
And you know, and I told you guys he was gonna love it. So,
okay.
Right there, speechless.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think Michelle at Barnes & Noble River Oaks. Thank you so much, Michelle.
Thank you. Was she considered Princess Zelda?
She was. She was the lady at the fifth stop.
The fifth stop, man.
So, yeah, she hooked it up.
There wasn't a princess in this castle.
It was a really cool event, man, and I thought, you know, something like that is very unique. I don't see stuff like that very often here in the city. Hopefully Barnes & Noble put something like that on again in the near future. I know it's kind of like in the release of, like, books, their bookstore.
Yeah.
But, you know, I mean, it was just super cool, you know. So, yeah, shout out to Barnes & Noble. Good job, guys.
Thanks, man. That was
cool. All right, next up, we're going to be talking a little bit, well, not really talking, we're going to be doing a little bit of ranting. John has something he wants to talk about, and this is regarding the Power Sword, the Legacy Power Sword from the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. There was a bit of an issue that happened just recently, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so take it away.
All right, well, I will take it away. And this is what I'm going to talk about, is that damn Power Sword, all right, because I got an email a couple weeks ago saying, hey, check this out. I pre-order a lot of stuff, so I get a lot of, you know, early access pre-orders done, right?
Yeah.
Right. So I get this email and it says, hey man, here's this blah 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 Power Sword. $74.99.
Blah 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 Power Sword.
Yeah. And I'm like, blah blah, take my money, you know.
No, the blah blah.
So bam, I pre-ordered, and it's real cool because they don't just take the money out of your account just in and there. When it comes in,
whenever it ships, right?
Yeah. And usually, you know, like I said before in past podcasts, that they've been doing really good about sending you some emails saying, hey, you know, here's a heads up, a couple days heads up, you know, so just get ready for your money to get stolen.
Yeah,
and
for your money to get stolen.
Last week, when David was doing his Hyrule Hunt thing, Zelda cool thing here, man, so cool. Was it the same thing?
It might have been.
It may have been, yeah. And I get an email, and it says, hey, just wanted to let you know that, you know, the item that you pre-ordered, which was the Power Saver or whatever, the company, I think they're called
Diamond Collectibles or something like
that. Diamond Collectibles, they are no longer sending two swords per box. And I'm guessing whatever it is that they buy, for instance, if it's like the legacy figures, a box comes with a lot of stuff, and two swords were supposed to come in each box. So since they ordered God knows how many boxes, they were planning on getting...
So they were under the impression that it was two per box.
Two per box, right, yeah, for $74.99. And then since they said Diamond Collectibles has changed their mind and they were sending one per box, and it was due because of the demand or something like that, or something, and they changed, so now it's one per box, and it's then ridiculous. They raised it to $149.99.
Double the price.
They doubled the price.
So basically, you know, they thought that there was two coming in a box. There was really only one.
Yep.
So that's why initially they had separated, they had half the price for two, you know, 70, 74, you said. So yeah, it stinks, man.
It does. It really does. I'm
trying to watch my mouth.
And
I'm serious, but yeah, that stinks, dude.
And I pre-ordered it through BigBadToyStore.com. And yeah, it really chapped my ass, and I got really pissed. And you know, I left it there. I left it there, and in my mind, I was thinking, you know, okay, how many other people are pissed? Are we gonna start a revolution? You know, if that's the cost, I hope it does. You know, yeah. I hope we do. You know, I really do hope.
Hey, you're
you
like, know, hope we do.
I really do. I really hope a lot of people get pissed, you know, and we get together and, you know, we do something, burn a building or two, or but the thing two. Is that, so I figured, you know what? Well, fuck, you know,
knock over staplers.
Big Bad Toy Store is not the only place that does this shit, right? And so I went to Entertainment Earth, and well, I talked to David, and I told him, and I told him I was gonna go to EE, and he was like, "We're trying." He goes, "I have a feeling." Here goes David, and he's just shitting.
Okay, look,
shitting all
over
me.
He tries to make me out to be like this dream killer.
He is.
I'm not.
He is.
I'm a realist.
And he's like, "They're gonna do the same thing, man." I was like, "I don't know. Let me just check it out." So I went to entertainmentearth.com, and there it was. But it was weird because it wasn't $74.99; it was for $80.
It was a little bit more.
A little bit more. So I was like, whatever, right? You know, I'll do it. But when I tried, I put it in my cart and pre-ordered it. It wouldn't let me. So, and then a phone number come up. I called the number. I talked to a real dude, a real person. I said, "Hey, man, blah, blah. Well, this is what's going on." And then he pre-ordered it for me. Sent me an email. And I said, "Hey, I got to ask you something real quick." He said, "What's that?" I said, "This happened over here at fucking Big Bad Toy Store." And he's like, "Oh, I don't know, man. That's them. Whatever deals they have with that company, we don't do that." All right, cool. The next fucking day, I get an email from Entertainment Earth. Due to blah, 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 $149.99.
Due to blah, 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 blah.
It pissed me off. And as if things weren't even going, they weren't even going right for me that day at work. I called David. I was pissed, man. I wanted to burn shit down. I don't know, man. I don't know.
Like punching the air.
I don't know. The fan in me, the collector in me, wants to keep it. But dude, I mean,
it's a little pricey, man.
I mean, it's a really
big, it's a big
a
collectible.
Sword. Just pay the damn price for the soft.
It's a big collectible, but geez, that's a hell of a lot for, you know, a big old sword. And I hope that Bandai isn't going down this road where they're going to be starting to charge like crazy amounts for these props.
We see
and
it.
And I know that they're really nice quality. They are, and I give them that. But oh geez, man, it's like it's hurting people because they're releasing all this stuff at once. You know, and I was telling John about this yesterday that, you know, if they continue to do this, people are going to be like picky and choosy with what they get. And they're not going to like the results. They're not going to like the sales in the end. And I just hope it doesn't hurt the future of the legacy line. You know what I mean?
I see it hurting the damn movie line because the movie stuff's everywhere and nobody's buying that shit.
Oh, you'd be surprised, dude.
I don't know, man.
I mean, there's I think what they're doing is they're keeping it in stock all the damn time.
I don't know,
but,
man.
I mean, I've seen people just buy insane amounts of that stuff. Now, it's hurting a lot of the other stuff though too. I think like Ninja Steel stuff.
Ninja Steel, yeah, that's still lingering
hurt
around.
Too.
But that, I mean, that we plan on seeing that for a good while. You know
what
I mean?
But I mean, like I told you though, they just made a really bad business choice. I feel like anyway, in my opinion, at releasing the legacy figures, the really awesome looking legacy figures, Ninja Steel, and then the movie stuff all close together. Time, you know, and it's like, you gotta spread that stuff out.
If you go to your local Toys R Us, they did. They separated them. The movie stuff has its own little area.
Well, I'm talking about like releasing it, like, you know, in spurts instead of like, throwing it all out there at one time. But yeah, no, I mean, that really blows, man.
It does, you know. And I got more to say, but I don't want to say bad stuff because I can, man. I can unload. But the thing is that it's, you know, this is the second.
All right, what happened, John? You like, I see it in your face. You want to say something? Just do it.
All right. This is the one that really pisses me off the most, right here, because I'm a huge Castlevania fan, big Castlevania fan, and when they announced that they made a Castlevania NECA 8-bit figure, it blew my mind, because when NECA made those Castlevania figures, they were gone. I mean, go look on eBay. No one can ever afford them.
Speaking of Castlevania. Well, we'll get to that in a minute. Go ahead. I know you're going with this.
But
I didn't have that plan, but go ahead.
Go online and check it out. And just the assholes who own them are the ones that are ever going to keep them. They're the ones that are always keep them because they want a lot for them. And it's ridiculous. I mean, because it just blew up. Anyways, so what they did is basically they took that same figure, that Simon Belmont figure, and they used him as the 8-bit figure. And if you guys know anything about the NECA figures,
just different color scheme.
It's just different color scheme,
like 8-bit type of color scheme.
Yeah, right? They used the colors from like the Nintendo, the NES colors, and it looks so cool. But they had the cover from the first one where he's kind of like lashing back.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And then you see the castle and Count Chocula
on the
top.
The castle and the Vania.
Yeah, and the Vania.
And the Vania. And
it was so cool, man. And I ordered two because I was like, I'm not gonna open one. I won't open the other one, but I just want two, you know. And all of a sudden, no email, no nothing. I thought about it. I was like, wait a minute, where the fuck's my Castlevania? And I went through my order, my pre-order. It was gone. No, I don't no email, no nothing. I looked everywhere else, nothing. And I kind of did a little digging, and because I got pissed, I was like, I'm done with this shit. And I just, damn. But it's
Master Snowrun here says, I freaking love the first four Castlevania games. Yes, even Simon's Quest.
Simon's Quest?
I think that was like the second one, I believe, or second or third.
But yeah. That's the third one. That's the third, because a lot of people say that
those are some great games, man.
They are. They really are.
I love the storyline. That it was like, to me, it almost felt like a Highlander type of story, mm-hmm. because it was like generations of Belmonts along the years.
Yeah, the bloodline kept going, you know? But I mean, you're like, how long can you be in this Renaissance dark and gritty era? You know what I mean?
It's like, they just extended it like 600 years, 800,000 years.
there was no future. It just stayed wooden. Everything was wooden and brick.
But yeah, so I don't know. I love the series.
Yeah.
So it was really exciting for me to hear that they were going to be doing a show, a Netflix show at that.
Yeah.
Come to find out, I thought it was going to be a live action show. It's an animated show.
Oh, it's animated?
That's what I heard. So, I was kind of like bummed out when I first heard that.
Yeah.
But I was like, you know what? You can do a lot more with animation than what you can with live action. So I think I'm for that, man.
Yeah, I'm all for anything, you know?
Anything Castlevania.
If they do figure this out, I hope they get that dude that played Dracula on Dracula Untold.
Oh, Luke Evans?
Yes.
He was a good Dracula.
He was.
I really like that movie, though.
Put that dude in his Belmont. Oh, my God. That dude, I just...
Oh, yeah.
He could be...
Yeah.
I could see him being a man. Dude, would be awesome.
Yeah, that would be pretty cool. I dig that.
He was cool on the damn... the one with the Lord of the Rings. Not Lord of the Rings.
Hobbit.
The Hobbit, yeah.
Yeah, he was really good in that movie. He's pretty good in pretty much almost everything he does.
Yeah, he's pretty.
He's intense. He's an intense actor,
mm-hmm.
which is really good.
Give him a whip.
Whoosh. Oh my!
End of rant.
Anyway, so now on to my rant.
All right.
Not really more of a rant. More of like a man, I don't even know what to call it, because I was so mad. I really was so mad for like the first couple of days, there was a moment where I had to. I was gonna film a video, right?
Yeah.
And we'll get to what I'm talking about right now. But I was about to film a video, And sometimes, my wife always tells me, I wear my emotions on my face. So I was so stressed out, man, because everything was just going wrong, I felt. And I was about to film a video, and I hit record, and I started looking at myself. I'm like, no, I can't do this. I can't do this right now. I'm gonna look mad like the whole time. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Or just like, hey guys, how's everything
one
going?
Tone.
This is so cool. So I decided not to. But anyway, it has to do with Best Buy and GameStop.
Oh.
You know, I do these unboxing videos for like I call them Blu-ray buyers guides. For, you know, say a big Blu-ray, if you guys are watching on YouTube, you guys know what I'm talking about because you guys watch this stuff, hopefully. But, you know, whenever a big release comes out, like, for instance, this past one was Doctor Strange. I'll buy every version of Doctor Strange there is out there.
I don't even have that movie yet.
And it's a great movie.
I know.
And every version, you know, every special Steelbook or Target exclusive or whatever, what have you. And I'll buy them all and unbox them and show them off to the audience so that way they get an informed, you know, decision on what they want to buy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I was getting everything together for that. I pre-ordered a 3D copy, 3D Steelbook copy of Doctor Strange back in January from Best Buy, right? So that one was
yours,
set.
Yeah.
It was there. And then about 2 weeks ago, I was like, okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and purchase, you know, two other ones, the 3D and the standard Steelbook. I'll purchase those. So it's two separate orders. And comes time, I'm, you know, for them to ship and stuff like that. I see the one that I did 2 weeks ago gets processed first. So I'm like, it's weird, you know?
Yeah.
The one that I purchased, pre-ordered back in January, hadn't even been processed, hadn't been touched.
Sounds weird.
So I was like, oh, this doesn't seem right. And then give it like a day later and it got processed. I'm like, damn, like this is I already felt it going bad, you know. And I was like, oh, whatever, okay. So I'm keeping an eye on the tracking because, again, I try to do the videos as close to the release date as possible or earlier if I can.
Yeah.
And so I'm you know, looking at the tracking, and it looks like they're both around in the same areas. You know what I mean? So I'm like, okay, cool. That kind of sets me at ease a little bit. The one that I ordered more recently leaves Kentucky, and then it gets here to Houston, right?
Yeah.
The other one, still in Kentucky. I'm like, oh, this isn't good. So, you know, time passes, whatever, day passes, and then the other one is already being processed here in Houston. And getting, it's on the truck, says out for delivery. I'm looking at the other one, still in Kentucky.
Yeah, that's some bullshit right there, man.
I'm like, what happened? I get the ones that I ordered second.
First. Damn.
So I'm waiting, and I'm like, oh, man. I was like, and at this point, I can't do anything because it's in process, you know, in transit.
Yeah.
So I'm waiting, and it still doesn't get here. And this is already like a day after release date. So I'm like, okay. And then I know, and you know, everybody was very patient on YouTube because they were asking me, you know, like, hey, you gonna do the video? Hey, you gonna do the video? You know, are you gonna do the video? And I was like, yeah, I'm just waiting on one more delivery. You know, I'm just waiting on it. And still didn't come. 2 days after, still didn't come. So I'm like, okay, I'm in a predicament. I'm in a predicament. I was like, man, I was like, should I go, you know, just go buy an extra one? I was like, you know what? I'm going to go do that. Check online. Sold out already.
Yeah.
So I'm like, damn it to hell. So I email Best Buy very angrily. You know, I'm like, hey, man, you know, where's my...
Wrapped your hands.
I was like, look, I was like, yeah. I was like, I know this isn't your fault because once it leaves them, they have no, you know, power over where it is, you know, in transit. Nobody answered me. Nobody answered me, and I was like getting frustrated. I was like, oh my God. Okay, so I tried to send a message somewhere else. Nobody answered me. Finally, I was like, you know what? Oh, I sent him a direct message on Twitter to Best Buy Support, and nobody answered me. Best Buy Support.
Fucking dicks.
So I blasted them on Twitter. I was like, how in the hell is it nobody answering me when I've been, you know, da 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 da. I tagged them on it and all this stuff real quick.
Oh.
How can we help you, sir? I'm sorry, you know, is there anything we can do? Oh. Email me at da 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 da.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So, fucking dicks. Yeah, so I emailed them. I'm like, look. I was like, I know this is not your thing, whatever. I was like, but I'm having an issue. It's like, if you're, and I kind of made myself seem a little bit more important than what I really am. I said, if you're in the business that I, you know, then it's imperative that I was using big words too. I was like, it's imperative.
When you were you were typing what you're doing then?
Yeah. Yeah, I was like, it's imperative that I get my stuff on time. You know, I was like, from what I was seeing in the system, my order that I processed back in January got processed second, you know, and da da da. And oh, you know, they replied real quick. Oh, I'm sorry, sir. And da da da. You know, we're gonna give you a credit, and you know, I know you ordered the steelbook. We don't have a steelbook, but we'll send you this one instead.
Oh, that's a dick.
And I was like,
I don't need that one.
I don't need that one, right? And then so. The guy, I was responding to the guy, and I was like, you know what, screw it, I'll take that Blu-ray, I'll take it. And the whole plan was to do a giveaway for you guys. I was gonna take that Blu-ray and just give it to you guys here on you know, here watching. But the guy never responded back to me after that.
Oh wow.
And I told him, and he sent a refund, right, to my account.
Uh-huh.
I bought that Blu-ray with a gift card initially. Gift card that I no longer have. So he issued the refund back to the gift card. So I'm emailing this dude, and I'm like PO'd at this point. I'm like, how are you going to do a refund to a gift card that I no longer have? And I kept going, you know, I kept messaging him. Never responded. And I was like, the next day passed, and I'm like, I need a response. I need this resolved, like, now. No response. Next day passed. I need to get this resolved. Like, somebody needs to answer me. Nothing. I look on the USPS tracking, you know, for that other steelbook. It's out for delivery. So it got found somewhere and just put on a truck and then redelivered. I got the steelbook. But I still have no answer back from this other dude. You know, and it's like, it was frustrating, you know?
That dude needs a quick fucking kick to the balls.
It was really frustrating. And it was just like, that's terrible customer service right there.
Or what you do is this. You put his hands on the keyboard and you grab a bat.
Wham!
Yeah. And, wham! Keep him on there! And he's like, no! Keep making... Wow, for real? That's some bullshit, man.
It's terrible. And then the GameStop thing, I'll make that one quick because I kind of lingered on with this one. The GameStop thing, I ordered the Switch, you know, and the Zelda thing, as you guys know. I was totally under the impression that I ordered the Master Edition, which, again, I swear I did. And that's why I was very chill about it. I was like, oh, okay, I got it ordered. Cool. You know, I'm not going to worry about it. I'm not going to stress. I got it on pre-order. And I really didn't check back about it. Before it got shipped, I get a fraud charge fraud email from my bank saying, oh, well, you know, we're checking your account and GameStop was trying to charge you for, you know, such and such money. And then GameStop was trying to charge you again for this much money.
What?
You know, he's like, well, you know, if it's okay, then just go ahead and click yes.
Yeah.
I'm like, and this was like 4 o'clock in the morning. I got the alert. And I'm like,
were you awake?
I was then. I was like, sure, yes, you know? And then I hit yes, and I started thinking. I'm like, man, they're going to X my pre-order out. Like, they're going to put it next in line, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
Because they couldn't charge it. And I was stressed out about that, too. And then, so I started emailing GameStop, you know, later on in the day. And they're like, oh, yeah, it's because of the fraud charge. I was like, yeah, but is it open? Like, is it still, you know, there? Yeah, you just got to tell us, you know, if it's fixed. Like, it's fixed. You can go ahead and charge it. Oh, okay. Yeah, and then they sent me an email saying, well, okay, if you want day one shipping, if you don't have it already, then if you want day one shipping, let us know now.
It's a bunch of bullshit.
And I was like, okay, yeah, I want day one shipping. You know what? I changed my mind. I do want day one shipping. So that way I had it here in time for the podcast and stuff like that. And so I said yes. And then when they charged my account, it was just, it was like an extra $15 for day one shipping. So they charged my account and it was just regular, the regular price. So I was like, okay. I emailed them back. I'm like, hey, did you not get my, you know, message about the day one shipping? Oh, well, there's nothing we can do now. It's already been in process. Sorry. I was like, okay, but you guys gave me specific instructions. I followed those instructions. What's up? And then somebody, oh, hi, my name's Nikki. You know, yeah, I'm looking at your order. No, there's nothing we can do. It's in process. I get that. But my thing now is, why were you guys being like, did you guys just ignore it? Was it overlooked? What? You know, just give me an answer at least. So-and-so answer back. Oh, hi. My name is such and such. Oh, yeah, we're looking at your account. And no, there's nothing we can do. I'm like. And then I went on this big old like paragraph.
Dude, you know what they did, right? They totem pulled your ass.
Well, yeah, no, exactly. You know? And then I went on this big old like rant, you know, in an email. So big old paragraph worth of stuff. And then I pulled the same thing. If you're in the business I'm in, you know, I need service, you know, right away. And I needed this day one, you know, you're messing with my business. And, da, 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 da. And nobody emailed me back after that. But weirdly enough, my shipping was 2-day shipping, right? It still got here right on release day.
Oh, shit.
Even though, you know, it wasn't day one shipping. So
that's weird, man.
I don't know what happened, but. Cool.
I mean, it sucks. I mean, the only thing different from the thing that, you know, and I believe David. I kind of wanted to bust his balls about, you know, maybe he did order what he got, you know. But then I was thinking about it, I was like, no. When it comes to shit like this, you know,
I could have swore I did.
He wouldn't skimp on
something like that.
No. Yeah, he wouldn't skimp on it. So I'm sure he ordered that version of it.
I mean, either that, the only thing, again, giving them the benefit of the doubt, maybe I did make a mistake and I didn't realize it. You know what I mean?
No, fuck that, David. You didn't make a mistake. It was their goddamn fault. Them. I blame them. I blame them, Big Bad Toy Store, Best Buy, and fucking Entertainment Earth.
Everybody.
They're all
going to hell. They got it in on us.
Yes. And then David passed on the curse of crushing shit in the mail to me.
Oh.
David got. It's been a bad week, people. Yeah. David got a bunch of shit crushed in the mail. I got two I talked to, hey man, what's going on? Hey, what's going on? And so we're talking, and he's like,
sometimes. He's so tired. You sound like the Godfather.
And he's talking on the phone, and he's like, yeah, man, you know, I just, you know, bad week or whatever. And I'm like, all right, man, you know, that's cool. And I kid you not, I walked to my front door, opened the door, I got two packages, right? I got a Spawn figure in a damn bubble wrap envelope. And I look at it, and I already know it's destroyed. And then I Entertainment Earth, you're getting blasted again, you bitches. They send a pop figure to me. A pop figure is in this little bitty, what, like 6 by 4 inch little box or whatever.
Yeah, something like that.
They send it in maybe a 7 inch by 5 inch box. There really is no room there for bubble wrap or anything.
Yeah.
So one corner of it was bashed in. I opened it. The pop was okay, but the damn box was to shit. When you have these people have to understand, right? These people have to understand. To me, and I had this conversation one time with somebody on Hot Topic, and he was like, the guy was like, "Oh, I'm sorry, you know, it's damaged." I said, "Yeah." He goes, "Well, sir, you know, you got the item. What's the problem?" I said,
"It's damaged. It's damaged." That's the problem.
I go, "You don't understand, dude." I go, and he goes, "Can you rate your damage 100%?" And then he goes, "Well, how big
so
is?"
So it's completely flat.
You know, yeah. he goes, "Well, how bad is the damage?" I go, "Look, I'm gonna tell you this real quick, okay? If there's a fucking crease on it, if the crease didn't belong there, to me that's 100%. Because already it ain't worth the shit, okay? So 100%.
As collectors, and, you know, little things like that. If you see like part of the corner is like open or something like that, and it's nothing, if you're not a collector, it may mean nothing to you.
Yeah.
But to us, it's like, Okay, it's worthless.
Everything. It's yeah, worthless. I now. Mean, I have to stare at this shit. I'm not gonna lie, man. I walk into my game room, and I look around at my stuff, and I start smiling, man. I mean, and I'll go and I'll look at everything, and I'll grab it. That's why I open my stuff. I grab it and I'll hold the box and I'll look at it, and then just.
Start nuzzling on it.
No, but you know I take pride it's in my okay, shit, baby. Man. I got. But you know, all this shit is uncalled for, man. You know, it's David passed on that bad shipment did shit to me.
It really was just a weird week of just problems, you know, all around. Yeah. And
it ended yesterday for me because today I got something today and it was.
Yeah, cool. We'll see. And it ended about yesterday too for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Anyway, so we're gonna go ahead and move on from our complaints,
our rants,
and
you know what really grinds my balls into dust, David?
When you're balls gets grinded into dust.
Into dust, like on a grater. Wevel 1.
Star Wars, Wevel 1. That's the next one. We're going to talk about how we felt about, you know, the Switch. Our first impressions of the Switch itself. We unboxed it yesterday, as many of you all know. And I was pleasantly surprised. I really was. I felt like it was a very, again, going into it, I was very skeptical, very just like, I don't know how I feel, mm-hmm. man. But I'm going to get it anyway, because I'm just going to come right out and say, I'm a Nintendo fanboy, I am. You know, but I am going to call them on their BS, so,
yeah.
You know, whatever happens. And a lot of times they don't like that kind of thing, but whatever.
They show up to your house with swords and
hey,
stuff.
Hey, they didn't send it to me, so I'll talk all the mess I want.
I was surprised, too. I felt robbed. Apparently, somebody came into this house when me and David were here, and they robbed David. I mean, just literally underneath our nose, they robbed us. I feel robbed.
You feel robbed?
I feel robbed.
Okay, explain why you feel robbed, John.
Because, man, this is the system. This is the system, okay? The system. I think I'm so content and I'm so used to the fact that my console will be at home. You know,
you're looking. I guess you're looking more in the aspect of like, okay, here's a console, here's a controller, and that's it. Like, you know what I mean?
Yes, but also at the same
like
time,
it's more of like a.
I feel like I'm being like okay, because look, Nintendo started to just. I mean, man, they're going downhill. They're hitting jagged fucking rocks. You know what I mean? Rocks. Fucking sharp thorns and everything. They're just hitting their heads. Vital organs, man, just getting unleashed, open, splattered everywhere, okay? They're hitting every freaking rock down this hill, okay? But what they're doing really good right now is they're doing really awesome and portable handheld things, right? So they're just like, well, you know what? Let's put out another console. Stay with me on this, okay? It's going to be a console, but handheld. So David's just gonna say he loves it because he's a handheld guy. He's on the go stuff. Me too. But
okay, this is my side of it.
We got robbed, that, David. We got that, robbed. Look, they came in here. They robbed us.
The Wii U was. We were talking about this yesterday. The Wii U was basically already. It was kind of like the in between point. You know, the Wii was what it was. It was a home console. The Wii U was them experimenting.
It was a test.
With the it really is.
Messed up.
And they're experimenting with this, you know, handheld gamepad thing with a screen. So this is the next, you know, step where they're like, okay, well, now you can actually take it with you. It is a bit scary. I will say that. It's a little worrisome sometimes. You know, I have not even had it leave this house yet. You know, I do want to test it out. I do want to go somewhere with it. But it's this scary aspect of, like you were saying, the whole console is right there.
Yeah.
If you drop it or something happens, you're out of the console. Like,
check,
you know,
this out. This isn't really personal or anything like that, but I can understand. I can understand, but I snap to this. David's son comes in here, and he's like, hey, Dad, can I play the game? And David, go ahead. You know, go ahead, right? All right, this comes in. Son comes in. Dad, can I play the game? He's like, I got to be here when you do this, you know? And I was like,
yeah.
See, but because, I mean, to me, it's so sense. I mean, just,
six. That's why. And that's also the other reason, too. But it is very, I just didn't want an accident to happen day one that ever that I got it. You know?
See, and now I paid attention to that, and I saw that. And then I told David later on, you know, I was like, man, I really want one, but I don't think my kids are ever going to play it because I won't let them. Now, this is just going to be me, is that I know how they treat the Wii U. I don't want them treating the Wii U my Switch, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So there's just no way my kids will ever, they have to get old enough to buy their own, then they'll be able to play it.
I'm with you on that. It's a very scary scenario, having, you know, something that you just got $300+ in your hand, and then you're like, here you go run off with it somewhere. Not right now anyway. You know, so that is very scary. But I love the aspect because, okay, my thing was with the Wii U, I was already walking around the house with it. You know what I mean? I very rarely played the Wii U on screen. So I was already treating it like a portable device. Yeah. My biggest problem with it, though, was that if I was, like, say, you know, here in the Bot Squad production room.
Dungeon.
You know, and then I tried to go over to a bedroom or something.
Uh-huh.
It would lose the transmitter. You know, the transmitter would go low, and then the screen would go black.
Yeah.
You know, now I can go to the backyard or whatever, down the street, and still have it work. You know, so that's really appealing to me.
But why would you go?
Options. I'm not saying I'm going to, but if I have to, I will. What if I want to, like, while I'm cutting the yard, want to play Switch?
May go run over the neighborhood cat or something and shit.
But it's just the possibility or the aspect of, yeah, you can take it if you wanted to. I probably won't, just because I'm kind of scared right now anyway.
See, that's what I'm saying.
Right now.
No.
But my 3DS, I took that thing everywhere, dude. And I mentioned that before, but
that's
too.
A 3DS, man.
3DS is about like $250.
Oh, okay.
That's close to what that is.
I know, but in the mindset, you already know it's like the older brother of a Game Boy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Regular Game Boy. You just know what you're getting yourself into. You know, it's already programmed in your head, handheld, you know?
Now, I will say that, you know, I don't see, like the commercial where they had it, like, propped on the table. Everybody's barbecuing and stuff like that. Oh, hey, let's play a game.
Hell no. No.
I ain't doing that.
Ain't no friends getting around my damn sister. See, now it's that. Not even become a friendly now, game. Family.
I will say that the Switch itself, like the controls, the Joy-Cons, were surprisingly comfortable. I thought that they were going to be, like, you know, like, real weird in my hands. But they were actually really comfortable. And I actually kind of like them. I tried it out yesterday,
mm-hmm.
playing with the Joy-Cons loose,
mm-hmm.
and then playing on the actual controller, and playing it on TV. I tried to do it, like, in every yeah. aspect. And playing it on that control is actually not bad. It's actually pretty good.
Yeah.
But
I know you were looking forward to this one.
Yeah.
This one and the other one.
The Pro Controller. And then, but I prefer playing it like this, though.
Like that?
Because I know I have this. I have it here on me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that was the other...
Have you killed the battery yet?
No, I haven't. Not yet. I haven't had the whole, like, the biggest chance to play Zelda just yet.
Do it, David.
I haven't had the biggest chance to play Zelda, like, enough of it yet, but I'm definitely going to be playing it, or as it's otherwise called, neglecting my family for about a month.
David's going on vacation.
Yeah.
Nintendo vacay.
So, first impression, though, I mean, how do you feel about it, besides, you know, what you were saying?
I want them.
As far really as how do. It feels in your hands and stuff like that.
I love it. I think it's they didn't skimp off on any of the comfort. I mean, I love it. Like, I love the other Wii controller.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man, the visuals are so cool. I mean...
I was very impressed with the visuals.
And I'm afraid of the game that's going to come out where I do have to use these little Joy-Cons, you know, separately or whatever. Yeah. No, I'm kind of afraid of that. But I like them. I like them. I really did think, like David thought, you know, that they were going to be a little smaller. You know, but once I had them in my hand, you know what? I have big-ass hands, too. Is that, I, you know, hey, they're not that bad, you know? And the cool thing about it, they come with an extra little slip that goes on the side of it. So it kind of fills in the gap. So if you really think that that thin, the little extra connection on it, kind of, you know, it works out. And, you know, and it substitutes for the buttons that you can't reach, you know? And I thought it was cool.
So Luis Hernandez just asked, you know, have you guys tried licking the Switch's cartridge?
Oh, we talked just about yet. That.
We talked about it yesterday. We were going to do it. I'm going to go ahead and do it.
Wait, the cartridge itself.
Yeah, not this part.
Okay.
Just the actual plastic there.
And the reason why is because kids are known, when I say kid, little kids are known to put video games in there, and Dave just told me that what Nintendo did is they made the cartridge taste very, 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 very bitter. So when a kid were to do it, they would spit it out, you know. We talked about it. We were talking about doing it, and I guess we are doing it.
Game Over James here said, hey, my dude, what's up, man? Hey. He also said 1-2 Switch is so overpriced. I do agree on that. 1-2 Switch is just like that the game that we're talking about where you milk the cows.
Yeah.
I feel like it's priced at a full $60. Right. It's more of like it feels like a demo. You know, it should be at least like 30 or something. Anyway, I'm going to do it. Oh.
Really?
Uh-huh.
For real?
It tastes like I just like bit into like a citrus peel, like a lemon peel or
no
like,
way.
Yeah. You can do it right here if you want, like up here in the
for real?
Corner. Yeah. It has a weird aftertaste to it. It feels like it's coming on stronger now.
Yeah, that's weird.
That's gross. So anyway, I'm gonna wipe it off.
I'm gonna wrap that on my hand. That's weird.
So how else do you feel about the Switch and or Zelda?
we licked a game.
Yeah.
Zelda, like they were saying, you know, we sat here for a while. We were talking about, you know, what was going on and what we need to be done and everything for today's podcast. And I was playing. I didn't really get to roam around too far and venture off. But basically, what it seemed like is that, God, man, it's weird.
Yeah, I still taste it.
I mean, you know, the IPA is kind of neutralizing. But anyways. So it's pretty cool. They made, to me, it seems like they took Zelda or, excuse me, Link, or Zelda video game, and they put it into, what's it called? Into like a Fallout, you know, type.
Yeah.
You know, you have to fend for yourself. You have to cook, and, you know, you chop a tree down, you know, wood is, you know, on the ground for you to take. What you're gonna do with this wood, I don't know, because we haven't gotten that far into the game.
Gotta get that wood,
you know, in the morning or whatever. So you get this wood, and apparently it's gonna be used for something, you know, acorns, deku nuts, stuff like that. I've seen a bunch of, you know, things, weapons, you can break them and you can remake them, kind of like Minecraft and stuff. I mean, it seems really, really cool, man. I haven't come around any bad guys yet or anything
besides like the bokoblins, like the regular little guys
that I didn't come out, you know? No, I didn't come across anybody.
It's a great it really is a great game. There's so much to do there, and so substantial as far as like space, that if you run in one direction, you're like, oh damn, I need to go in this direction. You're running all across the field. Now they do have like a traveling system that if you like, it's kind of almost like save points in certain like towers, where you can just travel fast between towers.
They did that in the Lord of the Rings game.
Yeah, they did.
Shadow of Mordor. They did that in there. Okay, and one thing that I thought that was real cool, what they did with Link is they gave him the climbing ability, where I mean, he could practically just climb anything, you know, and he was real quick about it and everything. Just you know, climb and scale stuff. Another thing too is I wanted to go crazy on some grass, so I started cutting shit down. But then he started to get exhausted, and he, like, when he would swing a sword, he was like, ugh.
Oh, yeah.
He has, like, a stamina meter.
They gave him that. So it looks like they're looking for, like, the, almost like the realistic, you know, version of this game. It's weird, very different, and we've never seen anything like that before. But, and do you think, like, after the story's gone, like, done, like, they made this game so where you can just keep playing?
It seems that way.
Because I
like the way Fallout is.
Exactly. Yeah. I kind of got that from.
It seems that way. Like, you can go and replay certain areas and stuff like that. And
like, you already defeated evil, so just keep living.
Yeah, you just, like, LIVIN.
Living Hyrule. You know? Dude, I didn't have a shirt on either way, you know? I'm just sitting here with my shirt off.
My son was like, why is he naked? I'm like, he's not naked. He has shorts on.
He has sandals on. It's cool.
Yeah, so we're going to go. That's kind of our first impressions of of the Switch. So so far, I think we're pretty happy with it. Like I said, we will be talking more about it in upcoming episodes of the podcast.
We got Rob. Like that.
As far as we shut up, as we keep playing it more and experiencing it more, then we'll definitely be talking about it a lot more. But next up, we're gonna go ahead and talk a little bit about Logan.
Oh man,
I'm gonna make it very spoiler free. Very spoiler free.
Spoiler alert.
I'm making it spoiler free. So, so Logan was. I mean, okay. I saw it earlier today, and even before I saw it, people were just like, this is the Wolverine movie that you're going to watch. Mm-hmm. This is the X-Men movie that you have to watch.
Yep.
They should have done this a long time ago. And I got to say that I am completely 100% in agreement with that. It was that damn good.
Oh, damn.
The running time for it was 2 hours and 15 minutes. So it was fairly lengthy. It was pretty long.
Yeah.
And, you know, from start to finish, it was just like, it was a different kind of movie. It gave you all the drama that you wanted from, like, an Oscar-worthy type of movie.
Yeah.
Very dramatic. Sad as hell. You know, it had everything that you would want in, like, a superhero movie.
Did you cry, David?
I almost did.
Really?
I'm not gonna lie. It got that intense.
Was it just you at the theaters, or was it you and your family?
No, it was me and Monica.
Okay, all right.
And so yeah, I mean, it was one of those. Oh, man, I'm trying not to give too much away.
No.
I don't want to give too much away at all.
Don't. I'll kill you.
No, but it was. Okay, if they don't give this movie some sort of awards recognition, I would be really shocked. Really? Very shocked. You know how everybody felt about, like, the Dark Knight Returns? Or the Dark Knight, I mean?
Yeah.
With the Joker and all that stuff? This feels like that.
Really?
Like, it feels that. It felt that serious, you know, that intense with every scene that presented itself. I thought that this movie was a fantastic bookend to a character that Hugh Jackman has played for over 17 years.
Damn.
This was the perfect, like, you know, you have his beginning in X-Men 1. And even you follow and you think about all the, you know, movies that he's been in.
Yeah.
And good or bad, to me, I see it as a journey.
Yeah.
To this point. You know what I mean? And this is the movie that solidifies him as this character. It's gonna be very, very hard for anybody to come in and replace him.
You can't be saying stuff like that, David, because to me, those are spoilers.
No. I'm saying in the future, because he already said that this is his last movie.
And that guy says a lot of things, okay?
He really means it, though.
No.
Even Patrick Stewart. He said he doesn't want to do Professor X anymore. Like, he's done.
He just don't know.
But, you know, it's going to be very hard for somebody to come in and be Wolverine again at some point. You know, because all I'm going to think of is this performance here. Because he was top-notch. This is the one thing that I never understood with Wolverine and you know, and the other movies that he was in, was that Hugh Jackman is a awesome actor.
Yeah.
You know, he's been in movies that were Oscar nominated. Put on great performances. I don't understand. Well, I guess I do understand, because it could be writing and things like that, story, but you know, why he couldn't give that kind of performance to an X-Men movie.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I felt like there was a lot of untapped potential in his acting in those movies, and finally they let it all out in this movie. Like, I mean, the one thing that I do appreciate, though, is that they didn't go back and talk about, like, in depth, oh, well, remember when Nightcrawler, you know, was here? You know, they didn't do none of that. So they very seldomly, like, even mentioned anything from past.
The past.
Which was awesome, I thought. It solidified, it was just like, it was perfect. It solidified it that time.
That movie in its own, yeah. Yeah, yeah, that's cool.
And it, it was, yeah, it felt very much like just standalone. Which,
tie-ins? Any tie-ins?
Slightly.
Okay.
Very, very, very slightly. If you kind of kept your eyes peeled.
Yeah.
Very slightly. It was the violent. There was a lot of violence.
Great.
Yes, that's what kind of
how it should be.
That, yeah.
Oh wait. How it should be, Aaron.
it was one of those where, you know, it was like, it was so violent that it was like, whoa, but at the same time it was like, yes,
yeah,
like that's exactly what Wolverine should have always been.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I mean, it reminds me a lot of those, do you remember the Marvel Comics Presents double-sided comics where they would give like a Wolverine story on one side and then
flip it upside down on the other side?
Yeah. Man. Well, those stories of Wolverine were always really dark, you know, and the art in it was very like very sketchy looking, like, you know, and stuff like that.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it reminds me of, like the ultra-violent, you know, type of stuff. Fantastic. Loved it so much. I heard a rumor also that they were planning on doing a black and white version of this movie.
Oh,
and
really?
And I think that would be perfect.
Damn.
That, just like they did a black and white version with Mad Max Fury Road.
Oh, they did?
Oh, so good.
Wow.
So freaking good. Very surprised how that came out. So I'm all for doing a black and white version of this movie. I think it would make it perfect. The acting, that little girl, dude, you know, that
X-23,
yeah, she's top notch, dude. She's only been in like one other thing,
really,
in her life, and her mannerisms, her facial expressions, on point, dude. Like, just, you just see her, you know, like, it's like you're looking at a little Wolverine.
Yeah, right.
You know? A
little beast.
Yeah, and it was so cool.
You know what? I didn't know they were actually gonna do this, because I mean, they hadn't done it, but up until before the movie was released, they finally showed it. I didn't think they were gonna show her third claw.
Oh, I know.
And then the trailer, they did
scraping on the floor,
the ground, and she was screaming. Yeah. Like, you know, the like her and like how David mentioned just right now, like she went from screaming. And then her scream got dark. It almost sounded like Logan, kind of.
Yeah,
you know,
very much so.
When she did
actions, the way she would hunch over was very much like Logan himself.
It's so cool. My kids were like, you know, she was like, so this new movie, you know, he has a daughter, and I look at her and I was like,
you don't even know.
I did. I treated her like that. I was like. Man, get out of here. You don't even know, man. Just get out of here. Don't be asking me questions like that. What's wrong with you? Go to your room. it made me mad, dude. I was like, how dare you?
But no, I mean, the movie was just, there's a lot of moments where it took me aback. I'm like, whoa. And there's even some nudity in there. But don't talk about it too much. But anyway... But
they show Patrick Stewart naked.
Yeah, they did.
Oh.
No. But I think that, and without giving any spoil, I will not spoil anything for you guys, because this is a movie that I really want everybody to watch. But
we'll spoil it next week.
Yeah, actually, yeah, we could. But so, you know, Patrick Stewart in this movie was amazing. Like, you know him as Professor X all these years, and he was this very, very powerful person, very, just leader. But in this movie, it's like the roles were switched. And you know how, like, in usual X-Men movie, it's like he's kind of like the father figure to everybody else, especially Wolverine. In this movie, it's completely opposite. Like, Wolverine is like this father figure to Xavier at mm-hmm. this point. And it's like he's taking care of him. He's his caretaker. And just to see, Xavier, that feeble and that, like, just so he's like out of it, was very sad, man. It really was. It was just, when you see it, you'll understand what I mean. When you guys see it, you'll understand what I mean.
Xavier was in hospice.
And and it was an emotional journey throughout the whole thing. I mean, and there was even, the thing is that as serious as it was and as emotional as it was, there were still moments for humor.
Yeah.
Not
I bet.
Not overly like humorous stuff, but still like the little tidbits of funny stuff. And that gave a really nice touch to a movie. And like I said, it bookends this journey of Logan and Wolverine himself, Hugh Jackman himself also as a person, as an actor, perfectly. It bookends it perfectly. And he did state that this is his last movie as Wolverine in the X-Men franchise. This is what he says. It could possibly not even be. For all we know, they were kind of trying to explain that this movie was kind of like we were saying, a standalone, kind of like in its own universe in a way. So where it kind of didn't touch anything else. So in a way that's kind of good too, because it gives the freedom of, maybe what if he does want to come back?
Yeah.
So this is kind of like a, I don't want to say a big what if comic, but somewhat to that sense.
Maybe if.
Yeah, but it was, I don't know, it was just perfect all around. The whole two hours and 15 minutes of it, I very rarely come across a movie that where I'm watching it and I'm like, I don't want this to stop. Like, I don't want this to end.
Yeah.
And inevitably, of course, it does have to. But it ended on a great note.
What was a movie like that? What was the last movie you thought that?
Oh, man.
Biodome.
Biodome? Yeah. I can't, I was trying to remember like a quote from the movie. I can't remember. Can you?
The peanut butter when he farts and he's like, oh, no, quote. Squirrely! Sort of position.
So definitely, Logan, go see it. You have to see it if you guys have not seen it already.
Any extra things at the end?
No extra things at the end. There was that Deadpool teaser in the beginning, though.
Oh, if you guys haven't seen that yet,
yeah, there's a Deadpool teaser in the beginning. So of course, come early, go early to the theaters for that if you guys are gonna go watch it.
Was that trailer, or was that just like something like right before the movie started?
No, it was after the trailers, right before the movie started.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So it was like a trailer right attached to the movie.
So have weird. Your damn popcorn and your drink ready, motherfucker.
Yeah, so don't go in late.
Get ready for this shit. It was pretty cool.
It was pretty funny. I won't say nothing about it, but it was really good. One thing that I did spot, though, I will say, there's a scene where it does say Nathan Summers is coming.
Nathan Summers,
Cable. Yeah, that's all it said. It had like a posters of Firefly in the back and stuff like that.
Really?
Yeah. Weird. Anyway, so yeah, Logan's great. Go watch it, because I said so. And I very rarely, I don't like to give scores very much, like when I'm talking, like video wise. But I will say it's 10 out of 10.
Okay, would you take your son?
No, it's rated R.
Would you take Dom?
No.
Damn.
I don't know.
Well, because I have my kids, and I if I go, I can't go by myself. I gotta take my wife and kids tonight. You know, damn.
No, I would say no. It's not. It's not that. It's not that family friendly. No.
Damn, Marvel.
Yeah.
Damn. All right. So I see date night coming soon.
Yeah, for real. I would say save it for that because it's really good though, man. It's really good. It's so dark, but it's so good. So yeah, that's Logan. All right, we're gonna go ahead and you know what? Before we get into this, let's go ahead and show this off a little bit.
Yes. Okay. All right. Since you guys, those of you guys who don't know and who do know, the ones who do know, this is and you're looking at it and you're like, man, I want that. I'm sure you do, man, because I was the same way.
Well, too bad.
Well, if you don't like it, you can get out. This is the Hakiri Megazord, okay? Now, if you guys already know, there's probably about 8 other versions of this thing out there already, okay? There's this one, the first one, the regular. Then there's the battle damage. Well, all they did was get a... They got the first one and got a little bitty black, like,
threw it on the ground a little bit.
No, they got like a little black paint, and they just kind of like filled in the edges here and there and called it battle damage.
Or it looks like rusty or whatever, like,
yeah,
dirty.
You got a little dirty on them.
Got a little dirt.
So,
I'm gonna fall into some mud. I'm like, damn, battle damage.
Battle damage. I'm gonna charge myself even more money now. So then they have, the regular one, the battle damage, and they had like these two different blue ones, okay? And they were kind of like clear blue. One was like more blue than the other. The other one was a little bit of light blue, but see-through. And those were kind of expensive. Like immediately, one day, already $100-some.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Apparently, this goes for about $100. I don't know why, but it does.
You don't know why. It looks amazing.
That's I don't know. It does look amazing, but...
1,500 pieces. That's why.
I guess. Whatever. It's $20 in the store when you buy it.
$20 in the store?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, Walmart. And they only get every... And selective Walmarts get them two per box.
Really?
Yeah. And,
Oh, his hand's battle damage. I
don't know. It's a mistake. It's a...
I'm just saying.
Battle damage. I know.
Sorry. Oh, my God. I can't believe I just did that.
Both hands, dude. It's just been busy. And, anyways, so, there's a couple other ones. There's some red ones and some yellow ones, and, yeah.
Is there one, like, a sparkly one?
Yes, there is a blue one, yeah. You know what it reminds me of? You know those rocket,
like, soap?
Hard candy, candies?
Oh, yeah.
You remember they
were candies?
Yeah, but they were, like Christmas trees, kind
of. Oh, yeah.
Astro something? Astro candies
Astro
or something.
Pop or something. I don't know.
Yeah, I think it was like Astro Pop or something. Like different layers of color. That's what these at least remind me of. I just wanted this one. I just because it's, you know, it's the original.
It's really nice. It really is.
And well, anyways, the Emerald City Comic Con, they came out with one. And it's green. Looks cool.
Oh, really?
That looks real cool, man. And he's going for about $80. I'm sure scalpers and stuff like that are like, oh. $1,000, you know, because you're
handmade
and
crafted. Wow.
But yeah, so that's what he is, you know. And he came out around the time I got the
big head.
Well, supposedly what people call the other little Power Ranger Pops, the soaps. And all they are is the teleporting rangers, you know. But if you ask me, and I've been keeping an eye on it, since they're releasing, it's the same mold of those three rangers that were hard to find.
Oh,
white,
yeah.
White, red, and pink.
Yeah.
It's that mold. All people have to do is just paint them.
Just repaint them.
And then, you know.
They can hide the fact that they're not that.
yeah, you know. And I mean, and the box itself already shows them in the same pose and everything. Now you have the box in the same mold.
Oh, yeah.
And I've noticed since these...
So people, you guys need to be careful.
Yeah, be very careful, man. Be careful out there for scammers and stuff like that. And pay attention, you know. So I've noticed that the white, red, and pink, the prices have depleted big time.
Really?
Very much, man. That White Ranger, the one you used to have, that went for about 200 bones, 200 plus bones, is like for 140 now.
It's probably because of the second, the one that came out.
See, and this is my argument still stands on what everybody out there, and no hate, man, because I follow these groups and stuff like that, and I know some of the people there, and they're nice.
I mean, though 140 is still really good for just selling a pop.
Yeah.
But if you wanted to sell it.
But don't sit there and tell me, you know, oh, it's vaulted. You know, that they'll never make another one.
Yeah.
And that means that it'll always be, no. They're always going to come out with another version. It doesn't matter. I mean, it may not even have the same pulls, but if they come out with multiple ones,
it's going to hurt the price of the original.
It is. It really is.
And honestly, to be honest, I'm kind of glad that I sold mine when I did.
Yeah. I thought about that too, man. I was like, man, you know, he got it just in time and stuff, you know. But I know you didn't want to part with it, but you,
I didn't.
You know,
I didn't.
You had to.
It hurt really bad, but I did it.
But yeah, that's what this is, man. And if you guys are lucky enough, please go out there, man, because you know Walmart, the selective Walmarts, when you go and talk to them, they don't know, so they may not have gotten to the box yet. You know, so you know, ask them, and they'll check it out. I mean, you might be lucky. You might even get the blue and the clear one. Those are more. I mean, like
even more rare.
Yeah, more rare, and because like this says 1500, those blue ones they're 500, you know.
Man, what if you got one that's like five?
Like, no, that'd be great, but no,
but nah.
That'd be cool, man.
So all right, so we're gonna start moving some of this stuff out of the way because we're gonna be doing something here that we like to call the Oreos of Doom 2.
That's not even a number.
It is a number. Just can't write right on there. Anyway, so we have three towers here. I'm going to take these off. All right. We have here, I think it's 17.
Looks all funny.
Why does it look funny?
Because it did pretty good.
I think it's 16 or 17.
I see 16.
16?
Yeah.
Okay. 16. No, it's 17. Oh, so 17... little cups here, and as you all know, if you guys don't know, usually
did Monica switch these up?
No, Matthew did actually. All
right.
there's usually something very gross under these, something very bad under these. We're gonna be calling out numbers, or actually asking you guys for numbers. You guys call out the numbers, and we will start picking from these cups. We'll pull them off. There's an Oreo underneath. Six of these Oreos are bad. So 6 out of 17. So that's a pretty decent ratio, right?
Yeah. Fair. So how many bads do we have to get?
We'll do 3.
Alright.
No, 4. We'll do 4.
If we get one and you're a loser, yeah, it doesn't matter.
I know. There's nobody really wins in this, challenge.
So this is going down. It's going to be me v. David. Okay. Battle pose.
Okay. Hold it.
That's good.
Okay.
That's pretty cool.
That's thumbnail right there. Anyway, so... Alright, so... start calling out numbers whenever you can, so that way we can start kind of, you know, getting a string of numbers going. I don't know.
Oh.
Okay, first off, but while they're putting in numbers, there's some really bad ones in here.
Okay.
Okay. Well, you know, we'll come to that
one. I left my olives here the last time, so.
I think they got tossed.
Oh, man.
Nobody likes olives here.
Really?
Oh.
Okay. Grab that bottle cap. That's gonna be our flipper.
Okay.
Unless we do the
oh, rock paper scissors. We don't have any cups.
For?
Oh, in case we hurl.
No, I don't think that's gonna happen.
I don't know, dude. We need to spit something anyway.
Okay.
All right. Wait. Keep them entertained, John.
That's all I got. All right, guys, let me tell you something that happened to me today. All right, I went and picked up my motorcycle today, man. I caught in the rain, and I was repping my new shirt, man. And I was like, nah, don't get it dirty, you know. But yeah, it didn't, and I made it and everything. I got this off of RIPT, and we've talked about them a couple times. We talked about them on some of the other stuff we've given away and stuff like that. They're real cool, man. You guys got to hit them up. And this is that reference in the Queen, you know? So you got, you know, it's a cool shirt and everything.
Can't say enough, Josh. Shut up. All right, okay.
Let's do it. Let's go. Okay,
go ahead.
I feel it. I already know. So.
Okay. So there's one for you. Okay. All right. So what's heads and what's tails?
Heads and
tails. Okay. All right.
But I can feel it.
You just let it fall.
Other than it fall.
Okay. I'll say heads.
Tails. Looks like a sad face.
You go all first. All right. So first number. What do we got? Okay. Number 6.
Ooh.
Looking for 6.
It's number 6. Is it a 9 or a 6?
This is a 6. That's a 9.
Yeah, because it's straight.
Okay.
Remember, David. I think David at one point was like, "We're not doing this anymore." Not the Oreos thing.
This is you. This is all your fault. You mentioned Oreos of Doom 2. I didn't want to do this.
I mentioned it, but then you called me and you were like, "We're doing the Oreos of Doom 2."
All right, we ready?
So now we're doomed.
Oh no!
What is that?
Wasabi.
Oh,
it's a wasabi Oreo.
Thank God.
All right. Before you do that, are we eating, consuming, or
I don't know. We can try.
No.
I don't know if I can. Certain ones.
Let me smell that. Well, try it again.
No, I
look, look right here.
Don't shove it in my face.
I'm not. Yet. I promise.
Oh, it smells like mustard.
It does.
It almost smells like mustard. Yeah, you jerk.
I mixed wasabi with the cream. With the cream filling.
It almost smells like mustard.
Really?
Yeah.
Taste lick it. No, don't make the...
Dude, I'm done.
Okay, all right. Let's just do this.
Okay. No, wait. Don't get on the game mode.
Okay.
I'm going to pick that one next.
Oh, 7. Okay.
Because I like 7.
All right, so you got 7.
I like 7, yeah. All right.
One.
You know what it tastes like?
2.
Okay, go ahead.
No.
No! Apparently, David has a very, very weak gag reflex. Try the other part. It might taste different. Try the other half. It might taste different. It tastes sweet. I mean, well, duh, but I mean, like, it's like. It's not that hot, right?
No!
It doesn't mix. It's not a good mix, right? It almost tastes like ketchup and mayonnaise, huh? At least your body's all. Everything's all lumping, huh?
I'm crying.
All right.
It doesn't even taste like that. It's just, it's a texture.
Oh, look. Okay. All right. I'm going 7. I'm
7.
Miss Monica. Pick 7. So I'm going to go for 7. That's on David's plate over there.
Hold on. My eyes are like wall water.
I need a chaser. Is everything all clear and shit?
Yeah. Awesome. I can see clear.
Alright. Let's see. Come on. You gotta be on my side, Monica.
Yes! Oh, come on now.
Crush this cup. We got more numbers.
Look at my cup.
Let me see. Let me take a picture of that in a little bit.
Okay.
Oh, wait.
You take a picture of that at the end. Sure, it's going to get worse. Stupid. I hate you. Okay. All right. What's the next one?
4.
4. Where's 4?
Where?
Okay. Thank you.
Bring David some milk.
No. All right, I got 4. I don't want to pick it up now. I don't want to play this game. Let's just call it.
I'm ready for it. No, I'm ready for it. Submit.
Oh, no. Submit. This is dog food.
Let me see. Oh my god.
How's it happening to me?
Did you, you didn't put any of the cream in here? This is all dog food. It's all dog food. You don't even have a dog.
I know. I got the cat food one the last time.
All right.
David's a very animal friendly friend person.
I don't want to do this, John.
Oh. Is that milk?
Oh man. I don't want to. Thank you. Do it, David. Oh, I'm almost gagged right now.
Do it, David.
I don't want to do it, John.
David, do it.
I'm gonna shove it in your mouth.
Do it, David. Do it. I would do it. You gotta do it.
You gonna do it?
No. I said I would. And this guy, you gotta do it for them, man.
I did it the last time.
You gotta do it. Look, there's more number. Luis Hernandez said 9. So, Luis, I'll go for you. I'll pick 9.
Okay.
After David eats dog food.
All right, let's just do it.
No. Eat it. No, man. Chew. Man, oh my god!
I barely tasted it, and the smell kicked back.
Oh man, eat that last piece.
I can't.
Oh, you dropped it in there. Yeah, pick it up, eat it. No. You didn't even chew it long enough.
This is bad, John.
No, don't do that. Sorry, David.
Shut up.
Take me out. Alright. Poor David over here.
I can smell it.
The dog smell, huh? Alright. Alright, so I'm going Luis. Luis Hernandez. Dude, don't let me down, man. I'm on cloud 9 right now, dude. So,
Number 9.
It's right on your plate.
It's right here.
So don't let me down. Don't let me down. Right, David?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah! Hey, Lulu.
I hate you, Lulu.
Thanks, dude.
Oh, my God. I hate you all right now.
I'm going to say this, buddy. I'm going to say this. I need the cookie. All right. We got... One.
You guys probably can't tell, but I have tears running down my face right now.
1 and 8. Pick one, Dave. Eight. 1 and 8 are on this plate.
Oh, no. I will go with 8.
Ocho.
Oh. Was it regular?
Yeah.
Regular. I don't eat it.
So, what was it? We got to get 4. Right, 4 down?
I got 2 already.
Alright, so it's 2. Alright. No, I'll go with 1, okay? I'll go with 1. Keep
this helps.
Keep keep throwing in numbers, okay, please. Alright guys.
I just smell my cup.
No, is it the cup or is it the shit that's like lodged in your teeth?
I smell my cup.
Let me smell it.
Go ahead.
Oh, the dog food really like it. Yeah. No.
Okay, I'm not going to finish eating this one.
All right, 1. Who picked 1?
1.
Divius.
Yeah.
Divius. Okay, all right. What is that? That's a lot.
Oh.
Did I just lose?
That's a bad one.
That's lard.
Nope. Your worst enemy.
Mayonnaise.
Yeah.
Gross. This is gross, David.
Check me out.
Cause it's the Oreo is sliding off. That's gross, David.
And they said, you remind me of Good Mythical Morning. That's a great compliment.
That's not right.
I, I don't think you're gonna barf or heave like I did.
I'm not. I
think you have a stronger gag reflex.
I'm not gonna enjoy this, okay?
I'm not gonna enjoy this.
Enjoy this, sorry, my bad. I like mayonnaise, but on burgers and shit, not on Oreo.
Oh, okay. All right,
there we go.
God dang it.
Oh, Lord.
That is soft.
Take a big old bite. You gotta take a big old bite.
I tried to start biting it in, and the Oreo itself was soft.
Start squeezing out.
Yeah.
I think my problem is with texture. I get really grossed out with texture.
I like mayonnaise. I just know it's not. You know what I'm gonna put? It's a burger. That's what I'm.
It's a burger. I almost did a burger Oreo.
Oh, I would have loved that. Oh God, I'm thinking about it too much.
You should try to take a second bite at least.
No. That one.
Slimy. Yeah, that's bad. Okay, more numbers. Let's see here.
Oh, this is gross.
All right, number.
Man, it's just not mixed with chocolate, man. That's just gross.
Ooh, I'll go with number.
Oh, four. It was like salty wine.
I'll go with number five. It was salty wine.
I don't know, John. David.
I'm kidding, man. I'm kidding. Okay, I'm gonna go with number five.
Please get something bad. I hate you.
Yeah.
Woo. I saved my good
watch,
one.
Watch it be totally bad. I just take a big old bite.
I saved my good one.
Oh, yeah.
That was this, gross.
These good ones actually really help with the aftertaste, so. I'll take one bite. Wait. Okay, so.
Two. There's like three twos in there. Two. Yeah. I'm going two. Yes!
Good one.
I got two good ones.
All right.
God dang. Jesus Christ.
All right, so what's the next number?
All right, so what we got left is 13, 16, 15, 17, 3, 12, 10, and 11, and 14.
Yeah.
All right. Jesus Christ.
Oh.
To me, that's my worst one right there, my worst. And I picked it.
Yeah, one bad one so far, right?
I probably wouldn't have minded the dog food.
Yeah, you probably wouldn't have.
I've eaten dog food before, you know?
Yeah, you probably wouldn't have. This guy used to eat fish food.
Yes. Like and turtle food.
Okay.
Damn. Right,
15. I'll do 15.
I'll go 17. There's okay. 15 and then 17. I'll do 17.
God, Jesus
Christ. Yes.
Good. Good one. I'll save this one for later, just in case.
I got two. I'm saving those for later.
All right, so you got 17?
Yeah, I got 17.
Right.
And it's kind of see-through, too, and I'm kind of... Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, you got a good one. This isn't really going very well now, because there's only so many now.
Damn right. That means that it's getting narrowed down, and it's going to start getting bad.
Oh, all right? Lord.
Here we go. We got more people to check this out. More and more people are joining in right now.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Okay. So yeah, just pick a number if you guys are just joining in.
Yeah.
Oreos of Doom is what's going on. Pick a number.
Oreos of Doom 2.
We have gross Oreos selectively like underneath these cups. Pick a number. We have 14, 11, 10, 12, 3, 13, and 16. And we will go ahead and unearth that number.
And David's losing.
So 11.
2 to 1.
Next one. Okay. All right, I'm going to do 11.
That's on David's plate over there.
Right here.
Yeah,
I'm very nervous because I have this feeling I'm gonna get a bad one.
And who switched these up?
Yeah, Matthew helped me. Matthew helped me with this one.
All right, Matt.
Yeah, my son helped me with these. So, okay. Yes. Good. All right, another good Oreo. All right. So what's the next number?
Three. I got three. I'm picking three. Three. Yeah.
Okay.
Come on, three. Who is that?
3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3-3
Okay.
You on my side, bud. You on my side.
All right, I'll go
on my side, man. It's like we're riding a battle, dude.
Just I'll go
on his horse. I'm just.
I'll go 10.
Numbers are coming in 14. I'll go 14 after okay. you. 10 and 14. 14's on that. Yeah, I don't, man. Okay. All right, never mind. What'd you do? No!
It's a good one. It's a good one.
All right. So now it has come down to this. These are all okay. Up now. We have come across.
Okay, I'm just going to put them over here. These are the good ones.
David told me how many bad ones are in there?
There were six bad ones out of 17.
17. Okay.
So that's a pretty good ratio of good ones
to
bad ones.
And we've only come across three. So there's three.
Yeah.
That means that there's only one good one left. Yeah. There's only one good one left, and I already said
John's doing the math here.
I was, I already said I was picking 14, so that means either I get this last good one, and that kind of just kind of tells it right. This is the turning point right here. This is the turning point of this show.
Okay,
if I fail now, then we are neck and neck. Okay, then that means eventually. Wow, okay, all right, this is the turning point. All right, so 14.
Yes.
Son
of... Oh, my God. What is it?
Please be good. No!
It's a bad one.
Because it doesn't look like...
Because it doesn't look right.
It doesn't look right at all.
What is this one?
When you ever open up a damn box of Oreo cookies and it looks all beat up?
I don't remember what that one was, to be honest with you. What is that?
I don't know. Is it double?
I don't know. I'm trying to think. I'm trying to think now. What did I do?
You stuff peppers in this shit.
Oh, that's right.
I see chile.
This is ghost peppers. This is a ghost pepper Oreo.
Man.
You got it, but at least like half of it on one good a couple chews.
Man.
Couple chews, John.
Is this mine? Chews.
That's yours.
So now we're neck and neck. All right, cool.
Okay. I kind of would have rather had that one than the dog food one.
Because we've kind of like built this immunity to... Yeah. All right, cool. Jesus Christ. I don't remember what the ghost pepper tastes like anymore. Is that half?
Not bad?
No, not bad.
Really?
No, it's not. It's not.
You know, it's not bad.
Okay, it burns, man. It was good, like Oreo was kicking in.
God, no.
It burning on the bottom of my mouth. I don't know why.
I put a lot of seeds in there.
I saw that. Oh, my God. Whoa. Woo.
Oh, man.
Oh, beer.
Okay. So, next one. All right, so we got 12, 13, and 16 left.
Ooh.
So we're 2-2.
I feel like this eye was going to pop out.
You going to glint it? Sorry. That was still too soon. All right. So, all right. We have 12, 13, and 16 left.
12 and 16 just came in.
Okay, I'll do...
Woof.
All these are bad, aren't they?
No, there's only one good one. There's one more good one. Oh, my God.
Okay.
Dude, I forgot how the ghost pepper was, man. Almost good, but...
Oh, man, I want to go with 12. I want to go with 12, but I kind of also want to go with 16.
You can't do that, man. You can't be touchies.
No, I didn't do it. I had my hands on it.
You're feeling the power, man. You can't do that. Oh.
12, 16. Okay. What's telling me what? Okay.
No!
It's
that one you left your hand on.
Yeah. Okay, I'll go with 12. Oh, no.
That's three.
That's three so far.
I'm at two. What is that? Let me smell it before you say anything. Let me smell it.
No, you know what it is.
The peanut butter?
No.
Oh. Whoa, what the? Wait, hold on.
Oh,
I know what this is.
It's sardines. mixed with the cream of the Oreo in Louisiana hot sauce.
Hey,
you like those, don't you?
No, I didn't. I get that last time.
I think you just got sardines the last time. Okay.
There it is, right there. It's activating the little headache.
So this is 3-2 so far.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, did I? Okay, yeah, I need to pull this up. All right.
Eat it, David. Come on, at least one of them.
I don't know if I can eat it. Eat it.
Eat half. Half.
I don't know if I can. I can chew it as much as I can, but.
Okay, chomp down half and then chew that mother.
Yeah, I can. I don't know if I can swallow it.
All right.
I'll try. I don't want to.
Sardines are good.
I don't like sardines.
No?
No.
What was it doing in your household?
I bought it just for this. Oh. All right. Okay, they're telling me don't get sick. Okay. Easy for you to say.
Okay.
Sure. All right. Ready. One.
Louis, they're not disgusting.
Two. Three.
Chase down some beer. You want Louis? Nah, dude. Keep eating it. Nah, man.
I'm trying.
Hey, Misung Park, pick a number, dude. Because you picked 165. Come on now. Chase down some beer, David.
Hold on. I don't know if I'm going to throw up for real. I'm like...
Chase some beer, David. Chase some beer, David.
Okay. I'm good. Hey!
Oh, you know what we should do next time? Is whatever's left over... God, this thing's warm. Whatever's left over in the cup should be the last thing you're...
No!
Yeah, that's it. Come on, guys.
Okay, next Jesus. Number.
I couldn't look at that last one. No, don't do that. No.
This stuff is stuck in my teeth.
I know. I just...
John. No! Why'd you do that? No! That's gross! It grosses me out more than these Oreos. Alright, next number. Next number, do it. So we have 13 and 16 left. 13 and 16. So, alright. We're down to the wire right here.
This is the turning point.
You said that earlier.
No. All right, guys. So this right here is going to tell whether who wins or loses. No.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh, because, no, because I have two.
Yeah, I know. And if you get the good one, I'm still going to have to.
There's a tie. It's
whoever gets the good one, the other person still has to try to eat the bad one.
All right. So then there is going to be a loser.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. What's the numbers? I'll go 13.
13? Let's see. 13, 16. Okay.
13. You ready for this, David?
I don't know, man.
Are you ready?
Boom, boom.
Break it down. That is a regular Oreo, people. That means...
I can't remember what the last one was.
That means
16.
Was all David's.
And I am the loser. Oh, this isn't so bad. I still might vomit, though.
What is it?
Spam.
Oh, gross. Let me see this.
I like spam, but I don't eat spam like that.
Hold on. You know what this smells like?
What?
A wafer. It smells like a chocolate wafer.
Okay, it does.
I don't know why, but...
Like I said, I'm weird about texture. So that's what's making me like want to gag more than anything.
Everything that's been put in there has been mushy.
I know.
Yeah.
Spam. Okay. I'm going to do it. Okay. Let's just do it. I'm going to do it.
Eat this one. It's the last one.
I'm going to try to eat it. Because I kind of don't mind spam.
Okay.
But I've never eaten it like that, like without it being fried.
Oh, my cookie.
My cookie. Okay. All right.
Eat it, David. Do it. It's good. Is saltiness?
It won't taste right.
You know, because usually saltiness mixes good with sweet stuff, you know? Like the way the chefs, they're like, you know, oh, come on. They're just like, you know, like a donut. Bacon really complements donuts.
Oh,
you
know? Hell. Bacon's way better than this.
But it's like the brother of bacon. You know? It's like the belly fat of bacon. The belly fat of bacon.
Stop, man.
Yeah. Don't you think? It's like me.
Okay.
Oh, I thought you were going to eat it.
I can't. That was disgusting. That was, as much as I don't mind spam, that was disgusting.
What happened to the rest of the spam? Did you eat it?
Yeah.
You did?
Wait for breakfast.
Like, nobody eat this piece of spam over here because it's going to be for the Oreos to do. Stop doing that. That's gross.
Look. No, don't. Oh, no. I laughed and it got me in the forehead. All right. So I am the loser of the Oreos of Doom. Didn't I lose the last time?
No, I.
Or did you lose the last time?
You did lose the last time, I think.
I think I did.
This is the only game I've been winning yet.
And it's getting caught in my beard.
Gross.
So, on that note, we are going to end this episode of the Bot Squad podcast. Thank you guys for watching so much. And hopefully my vomit-inducing pain
yes
entertained you in some way.
God, David.
I have a couple of them I'm going to chomp down right now. Thanks for watching, like I said. Keep visiting cinemadeviant.com for all your movies, news, reviews, trailers. Visit facebook.com/cinemadeviant and go ahead and like that page. Snapchat is Cinema Deviant, Twitter at Cinema Deviant, Instagram, if you're watching on Instagram, thank you so much, and it's Cinema Deviant as well. John, what are your social networks?
Mom, I'm just like really enjoying this damn Oreo dip.
What are your social networks?
My social networks, Instagram, Bobbing94, as well as my Snapchat.
Uh-huh.
Twitter is Spawn94AEW. Right?
Yeah.
Spawn94AEW.
I think so.
And please, please hit us up on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
The numbers are rising, man, and it's getting great. It's getting so cool.
For real.
Yeah, I mean, the love. Like we expressed the last time, the love, man. You guys answering and stuff like that, I have, and David has, no problem answering you guys. You know, if you look on top two, it says we have 100% chance of answering your message within the hour.
Yeah.
And so, which is weird because we actually do it like that. But it just says within the hour. I don't know why.
It just says we're real quick about it, basically.
Exactly.
So, yeah. So, thank you guys for that. And, you know,
16!
Thank you guys so much for watching it and taking part in this dumb thing that we do periodically. We really appreciate it. And with all that being said, we will catch you next time. Bye.